are still in Christchurch. They'll be up here bright and early tomorrow, getting ready for 7 separate concerts of Michael Jackson that they're going to. 2 here in New Zealand and the rest in Australia. Now, the couple have been collecting Jackson junk since they were kids. Their home is full of it. In fact, it's known locally as Jacksonville.
Hi, guys.
Hi, welcome to Jacksonville.
Michael Jackson is alive and well in this quiet Christchurch suburb, thanks to adoring fans Quinton and Vanessa Wood. They eat, sleep and breathe Michael Jackson.
Oh, he's so unique. He's just, I don't know, he's just such a wonderful entertainer. He really puts his whole self into what he does, and if he hasn't got 100%, it's not good enough.
He's a true humanitarian. He's the sort of person that he won't sing anything unless he really means it.
The lounge looks more like a record store, life-size Jackson and all.
This arrived one Christmas. This is our pride and joy. My sister got this for us. She handed the one of the Sony wraps, and the doorbell rang one Christmas morning, and I got out of bed, and here was Michael standing at the door with a wee Christmas hat on, and oh wow, it was absolutely amazing. Made my Christmas day. Amazing. You know how
I feel. Vanessa's been a committed fan since the age of 12. And between the two of them, they own 60 Jackson videos, 300 CDs, and they've lost count of the records.
Do we have a favourite Michael Jackson song?
Oh yes, Billie Jean. Billie Jean, I'm going to wait to stand in that concert and just hear the Billie Jean drums. Yeah, that's the song I'm waiting for, Billie Jean.
People say they're mad, obsessed even. But this pair insists their hobby's no different from anyone else's.
Everybody's got something, whether it be sewing, golf, anything like swimming, your aerobics, anything. We just choose to do this, and we've met so many wonderful people through it and had great experiences. Well, we've got each other. I mean, what more could you want?
How about a house full of Jackson junk for a starter?
Come to the rest of the house.
And what's this, kid? What's this all about?
Well, we are counting down to our dream come true. We're going to see Michael live. And at the moment, it's another 48 hours and we're going to see him.
He's everywhere. He's even in the pantry. He's not in this room, though.
But his sister is. He's in every other room in this house, and the best is saved for last.
Absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
I've never seen so much Michael stuff.
A $30,000 shrine to their hero. The Jackson paraphernalia's come from all over the world. Shoes, American TV guides, German chewing gum, the works.
The doll, the hat, the chocolate, all of this, the true rewards of a real Michael Jackson partnership. So where did it all begin? Under Jay in the local record shop.
They both used to come in here and just sort of be quiet, lonely fans on their own. And then they came one day and I thought, no, hang on, this makes more sense if we'll just get Quinton to go over and like talk to Vanessa. Like, she's a fan. And then, you know, within about 5 minutes, they were walking out the door. You know, so you guys are going for coffee, eh?
The couple couldn't be happier, together in their own Jacksonville heaven and defending him to the hilt.
And what about these pedophile claims?
Horrible word. No. Michael didn't do that.
Quinton and Vanessa will be outside Jackson's hotel tomorrow, hoping, praying even, for just a few words with their idol.
Yeah. Without him, we wouldn't have this. Without him, we wouldn't have each other, because we would never have met in the first place. The girl is mine.